Welcome back to The Corner. All right, you see the title. Before we get into the story, let's roll the theme.
Hello, everybody. Welcome to my corner. Woo!
Welcome to my corner. Let's have a talk now. Uh-huh. From Miami to California. Yeah. Check your girl out. I'm going to give it to you straight up. That's right. That's right. Keeping it real. No things inside.
Let's go.
Welcome to my corner, y'all.
All right. So, y'all know I moved to Atlanta this past year. It'll be a year and a few weeks. All right. So, I moved to Atlanta. All right. So, with me moving to Atlanta, I thought the dating pool would be a little different, okay? Because, you know, the one in New Orleans got a little bit of dookie in it. I was like, all right, I'm going to try the dating pool. Right. So, being that I was in a new city, I was like, let's try this whole dating thing. All right, cool, whatever. But the thing is, like, where am I supposed to meet men? Because, like, I'm not your average 30-year-old. I don't club. I don't enjoy hookah spots. I don't go to the club. I don't be at a strip club. So where am I supposed to meet men at? Through these apps. I hate these stupid dating apps. Please, with all my soul, like, if you are married, listen to me. Stay faithful to you. If you are married, listen. Ain't nothing out here, okay? Y'all be thinking single. We're out here drowning. This pool sucks. It has piss and dookie in it. Please be faithful to your spouse. Love them with your whole heart. Because this stuff right here, it's terrible. So I got on the dating apps, right? Specifically Upward, Hinge. I didn't try Tinder again. Black People Meet or Black whatever, just a little too ghetto for me. So we did Hinge and Upward. Now I have two different stories, so I'll probably break this up in two different things. So let's start with the Hinge guy. So I meet this guy on Hinge February 15th. Now Instagram knows him as an experiment. I grab me an experiment, right? So everybody's excited about the experiment. Yes, let me tell y'all how this was a nightmare. All right, so we meet February 15th, we start texting, we're laughing, we're joking. We finally get the opportunity to FaceTime because he wants to see if I look like my pictures, which of course I do because I'm not a catfish. Girl, I'm fine in real life and out of life, ew. So we FaceTime. That day we FaceTime, we actually stayed on the phone for like 5 hours, just FaceTiming. Like we were just laughing and joking and kikiing. And so at the end of the FaceTime, he goes, hey Candace, what are you doing tonight? I said, I don't have any plans. He's like, you wanna go out with me? I say yes, but in my mind, I'm like, oh my God! Why are you gonna go out so soon? I don't think y'all understand. I am a very bold person, but men make me nervous. I don't know why. They just make me nervous. And so he's like, do you want to go out? I'm like, yeah, sure. Now mind you, he's new to Atlanta, I'm new to Atlanta, so we're kind of figuring out Atlanta together. So I'm like, okay, cool. He's like, so when I get up from my nap around 8, we'll go out. And so I'm like, okay, go take your nap. Now, mind y'all, while he's taking his nap, I'm in a full panic mode. I'm running up and down the stairs. I'm sweating. My pits are sweaty. I'm hot. I'm calling my girlfriends like, he wants to go on a date. What am I supposed to say? What am I supposed to look like? Mind you, my hair is not done, so I'm freaking out because I'm like, what wig am I going to wear? And so, you know, my friends are like, everybody calm down. I'm on a three-way with my friends like, what am I going to do? They're like, okay, first of all, Candace, relax. I'm like, okay, let me calm down. I don't understand why I got nervous. You know what I'm saying? So I got nervous. I calmed down. My friends are like, Candace, it's just a date. Like, he's not asking you to marry him. I'm like, right. You're right. Okay. So they're like, put on your wig, do your hair, pick out an outfit, and then go on the date. And then call us when it's over. So I'm getting dressed. I'm beating my face. I'm doing all these different things. It's now 7:45. He gets up. He calls me. He says, what are you doing? I was like, oh, I'm getting ready for us to go out. He was like, okay, cool. So when he gets up, he's like not looking good. And I'm looking at him like, yo, are you okay? He's like, no. He's like, I feel nauseous. He's like, I just threw up. He's like, hold on, I gotta go to the bathroom. So he like leaves me out in the kitchen while he runs to the bathroom. He's like, Candace, I don't feel good. I'm like, I think we have to postpone. And I'm like, oh no. In my mind, I'm like, yes, yes. Cause I didn't want to go on the date because I was nervous. Like, it's too soon. Like, man, look, when y'all first meet me, you can't just throw a date on me. You got to ease me into that. Like, we got to at least be talking for like 2 weeks before you just be like, hey, you want to go on a date? What am I supposed to do with my hands? I don't know. So he gets sick. We can't go on the date. And I'm like, okay, cool. We'll just make a rain check. All right. So we still are talking. We're vibing. Now we're into like a little bit of the end of February. I go to Florida and then I come back and my best friend's here. And so we're in town, my best friend, we're vibing or whatever. She's like, ask him, does he want to go out? I'm like, no. don't want to do that. Because she had heard us on the phone, like, he's calling, checking on me, asking me how I'm doing. He's calling, you know, just to see how my day was. Like, just everything you do when it's new. So clearly, the kid liked me, clearly. So she's like, ask him out. I'm like, I am not that girl. Cause baby, cause who? Cause you ain't finna reject me. So I did it cause she peer pressured me. And I was like, hey, you wanna go out? And he was like, actually, I'm not in the mood. You gonna turn me down? Wait, so did you hear what I said? I asked you, did you wanna go on a date with me? And you said, no. Do you know who I am? He was like, yeah, I'm not really in the mood to go on a date. Did you just reject me? What is, wait. So I was like, okay, so now we 0 for 2 cause we ain't never been on a date. We 0 for 2. All right, so we're still talking, we're still vibing. So now it's like March, right? So we're in March and he is actually trying to be in the academy. So he's like got a really, really busy schedule. So one day we're talking and you know how I am. I don't like nobody with no kids. So, you know, I just asked, I was like, why are you so attractive with no kids? I don't understand that. Like, what's going on? He's like, I don't have no kids. Like, I just don't. I said, okay. So then he's like, well, actually, I said, oh, so you was lying. So yeah, let me tell y'all. So basically what happened was he was dating this girl. He was messing with this girl and she told him she was pregnant. Okay. And then she said she lost the baby. Then she said she was pregnant. So randomly she comes back some months later and she's like, I'm actually am pregnant and it's your baby. So he don't really know if it's his baby or not, but like she a few months pregnant. So I'm like, so you could possibly be a dad? He's like, yeah, I don't want that to deter us. Like I really, he was like, yeah. He's like, but I hope that doesn't, you know, stop what we have going on. I'll know for sure in July. I said, well, if we make it to July, you'll know for sure if I'm your girlfriend by then. We'll talk about it. So now we 0 for 2 with no dates and you possibly have a baby on the way. It's giving me very much run. So we're cool because, you know, I'm just a cool person. So we laugh and we joke and kiki, and now we're in March and he tries to schedule another day. Okay, so he's like, let's go to brunch on Sunday. So I get dressed for brunch. Come Sunday, he's like, all right, I'm gonna meet you here. Well, y'all, right before I'm getting ready to get dressed and leave, he's like, oh, snaps, I forgot I have a paper due. Like, can we postpone? So now we 0 for 3. We have been kicking it since February. It's now almost end of March, April, and we haven't been on one date. It's giving pen pal. It's giving me, you want to write love letters like you're R. Kelly in jail. So, all right, fine. So now, end of March, April, I'm like, all right, I'm not waiting on you no more. Like, we good. Like, the feelings is whatever we had, is I swallowed it. It's over. So I go out of town to Rock City for Easter, and while I'm gone, he calls me. He says, where you at? I said, I told you I was out of town. He's like, oh, I want to go on a date. Boy, my mom would be watching this, but I want to say enjoy hell, but whatever. So we don't go on a date. So at this point, I'm kind of like just like I'm like taking my hand off of him because I'm just like, if you wanted to, you would. Like if you wanted to date me, you would come get me. So I'm finna just head out. So I stopped texting as much. I stopped responding, and then slowly we just stopped talking completely. All right, so I think we're done. Situation's over, y'all. One day I was out to brunch with one of my friends from Japan, and I come out the restaurant. I'm coming this way. I see this man walking with this girl. I'm like, oh my God, it's him. So I'm like in my mind, like, what are we gonna do? How are we gonna respond? Because he's totally on a date with another girl, and I don't want him to. And he stops. He's like, oh my God, hey, and gives me this huge hug in front of the girl. And I'm just like, oh. So now I know he about to text me and be like, yo, you're da-da-da-da-da in person. So like, I see him at like 1 o'clock when I'm going to my car. By 4 o'clock, he texts me. He's like, oh my God, you're shorter in person. I'm like, ah, LOL. I'm 5'3", literally what I told you the whole time. You're really gonna text me with that? So I'm like, yeah, you short in person too. He was like, but you look so beautiful in person. He's like, how have you been? Oh God, why do you guys do this? So I'm like, I've been great. Life is good. You know what I'm saying? Life was actually falling apart, but he didn't need to know that. So he begins to text me again. Like we're trying to kick, like he's trying to kick something up, but I'm like, no, you don't have to do that. Like just disappear. So mind you, remember he has a baby due in like July. So now it's like end of May, beginning of June. Yeah, nah, it's like end of May, early June. I got a baby due. So I'm like, so he starts texting me. He's like, yeah, I think it's actually mine. I started preparing for this. I'm like, oh Lord. Okay. So he's like, so how do you feel about that? There's no feelings because we ain't been on a date. You got a baby on the way. As far as I'm concerned, this is over. So we stopped talking. I'm thinking everything is good. Y'all, why he disappeared randomly? It was just like, you're so beautiful. I wish I would. Sir, you have a child. What do you want from me? So not only does he have a child, but the girl's also giving him full custody. So it's like, are you looking for a stepmom? Because I can't be that. So needless to say, the experiment did not experiment the way it was to me. It was too much, y'all. I can't do it. Mm-mm. So yeah, we're back at the drawing board. Now, I did meet somebody off of Upward, but that's a whole different story. Like, y'all gonna laugh. These dating stories are getting worse and worse. I met one man off Hinge. He had 4 kids. He just divorced his wife, and he was asking me, would I go to Six Flags with him? Come to find out, our families are from the same place. And I was like, we're probably cousins, but you also have 4 kids, so what did you expect? So, put it like this. End of the story is the experiment failed. I hate these dating apps. I just wish I could meet somebody at church and they take me out of here, but I'm pressed on towards the high mark and a high calling. So it didn't go well. That's experiment, whatever number I named him, it didn't go well. We're back at the drawing board. I will let y'all know how it goes. I keep collecting experiments and they keep failing me. So y'all just pray my strength in the Lord, please. But yeah, so if you're asking, cause y'all keep asking what happened to my experiment, he gone. He got a baby on the way and it ain't mine. So, you know, I got to disappear. So we're 0-2 since being in Atlanta, cause I picked up him and this other guy from Upward. I'll tell you about the other guy the next time we talk. So we're 0-2. I don't know how many more L's I can take. But if you would like to hear the rest of my dating life, stay tuned on the next episode of Candace's Corner. Make sure you guys like, comment, subscribe, hit the post notification. Peace.